Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for being here. My name is Jessica Cesar. I am a PhD student in the GOTL group from the University Carlos III de Madrid, where my advisor is Professor Guillermo Carpintero. The work that I am presenting today is being developed by our group and the millimeter and submillimeter team, led by Professor Luis Enrique Garcia, also from the University Carlos III de Madrid. All this is within the framework of the Martin Lara project, a millimeter wave array at room temperature for instrument in low altitude radio astronomy. We are all a consortium from the community of Madrid. Now, the goal of Martin Lara is to design a 6-unit CubeSat, where a new type of payload is developed for cosmological microwave background observation, zenith direction, and air observation for weather monitoring, nadir direction. This is just a reference figure. It's not our system of, say, unity. It's just for reference. As we all know, the CubeSat has an exorbitant volume and weight, so the system in it must follow some limitation. That's why our payload, which is the photonic enabled radiometer that I'm going to present next, is denominated as a new type of payload, where a photonic integrated circuit, PIC, is used to reduce size, weight, and power consumption, and by means of our conversion mechanisms, cryogenic systems, a requirement can be eliminated from the system, from the payload. So this is the scheme of our photonic radiometer, which is the payload of our Martin Lara project. The operation principle behind this system is the following. A multi-car carrier, can you see my pointer? Hope so.
Yes, we can see it.
Okay, thank you. An optical carrier is generated to be phase modulated by an electro-optic modulator, which is part of the Pound-Driven Hall logging scheme. After this, it's sent to a whispering gallery mode resonator through a green lens and a diamond prism. The goal of the whole system is the whispering gallium mode resonator, a lithium niobate resonator, which will be in charge of the upconversion to the optical domain of the microwave signal detected by the antenna, which is the radiometer input. The resulting signal from the interaction between the optical and microwave signal, this BS, is outcoupled by the same prism and sent to a splitter with a power ratio of 99% and 1%. The 1% signal is used as the input to the PDA's logging scheme in order to stabilize the wavelength of the optical carrier to a resonance of the resonator, just to lock in this wavelength. So the other 99% of the signal goes to an optical coupler to be down converted to baseband. The down conversion process happens when this signal BS goes to a pair of balanced photodiodes, with where will be beaten with this local oscillator signal. The local oscillator signal that is also generated by this optical wavelength generation system has a frequency higher than this signal going through the resonator. And the radiometer output will have a frequency that will be the difference between this local oscillator and this 99% signal. That's what we call an IF signal, because they will be beating in our balanced photodetector. The reason that why we are using this balanced photodetector scheme is to make a more efficient use of the energy, as the signal will be added and the noise will be decreased. The millimeter team will be in charge of the developing of such a resonator and the microwave coupling. Our photonic group will be in charge of the optical wavelength generation system and the PDH locking scheme. And together we will be working in the optical coupling and the operation of the radiometer in general. Now I will show you a few a more detailed view of each part of the radiometer. I will start with the heart of the system, the lithium niobate whispering gallium remote resonator. The group of the Professor Luis Enrique have developed an upconversion scheme to detect the weak radiation, millimeter and submillimeter wavelength, which is required for air observation and radio astronomy. All this without any needs of cryogenic system. The idea is that by passing the RF signal through a low absorption nonlinear crystal, which will be pumped by a laser, the microwave signal is upconverted to the optical domain, where the deltas are less susceptible to the thermal noise at room temperature. So that's a very, very good result. Some more analysis of this technique can be found in this paper from the millimeter team. Now, for the optical wavelength generation system that will provide the optical carrier and the local oscillator signal, we use an indium phosphide silicon nitride hybrid integrated dual laser mode from Lionis, which is based on micro ring resonator extended cavity lasers. This hybrid integration allows for gain section on indium phosphide while having low losses high Q resonators on silicon nitride, developing large lasers with low line width. Here we can see the red curve is the line width of laser one at different frequency. The green one is the laser two line width, and the blue one represents the electrical line width of the resulting signal from beating laser one and laser two. This is a picture of the component. These two are PD for electrical signal, forget the electrical signal. We also have the optical output from each laser independently. So in our radiometer, the laser one is used as the optical carrier due to its low line width in order to be able to fit in the resonance of the resonator, and also allowing to the PDH loop to follow more efficiently the wavelength drift of the optical carrier. So laser two will be used as the local oscillator source for the down conversion mechanism. Here in this table, we can see the different frequencies achieved by means of wavelength tuning. We have found several big note frequencies from 5 gigahertz until 150 gigahertz. So here we have room to achieve that radiometer output, that type of EF signal from 5 to 150. So we have plenty of space. This work, or this characterization of this component, was submitted to the GRT journal. It's pending to approbation. Now, last but not least, we have the pound-driven Hall logging scheme. This PDH loop is being implemented with RF component from X microwave, which offer modular building blocks for RF and microwave system. Here we can see some pictures of us testing the, I think this was an amplifier. Yes, this was an amplifier. They all have a very nice behavior. the final size of the PDH loop with this kind of component are 11 millimeter by 8 millimeter. It's very, very small. So that's what I was going to present today. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you, Jessica, and congratulations for such a nice project. All the projects that the group of Guillermo Carpintero makes. Congratulations to all your mates.
Thank you.
Any question for Jessica? No questions? Questions? I have one question for you. Which would be the next steps after you got this implementation?
Mm-hmm.
Which would be the next steps with this photonic integrated circuit? Are you applying it for new projects? Are you developing a new release?
For now, we are just making a proof of concept of this new type of radiometer, just to see if that works. Today, we have tested the whispering guided mode resonator and the photonic part. So the next step in our project is to join together to have the whole radiometer working on correctly. And after that, I think that we'll be more focused on the space mission, just to see if this component can be using some space CubeSat. I know that Lyonis is doing so microwave photonics for space, so that will not be a problem. The problem is this X microwave component. So after this, that will be the focus of our work.
Okay. Oh, good plans. Good plans. Okay. Thank you, Jessica. We have another question from Juan Pastor.
Yeah.
He says, dear Jessica, maybe you explained it. Do you have information about the required bandwidth and maximum input power of the balanced PD?
About the balanced PD?
Sí. Yes. Sorry.
No, we haven't done the whole system yet. We have we are going to integrate this, but we are expecting that this whole structure was created, but no, I don't have any idea about the balanced photodetector. What we are looking at is the radiometer input that will be focused on frequency of 180 gigahertz, 240 gigahertz, and 320. But I haven't got so far in our project to be able to answer that question correctly.
Okay, thank you, Jessica. Any other question?
Yeah, maybe I have a question. My chat doesn't work. Yes, I have a question. I must have missed Jessica at the beginning of your talk. So your objective is to generate a millimeter, a 10 millimeter wave for the radiometer. Is that correct?
Yeah.
And you do optically.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.
I mean, if you're interested, you get the millimeters, 50 to 150 gigahertz, and then some millimeter terahertz. Why not you simply GaN diode oscillator for millimeter, and then you use a multiplier to go to some millimeter? That would be much simpler. If your objective, of course, is to get, millimeter or some millimeter sources. Is there any reason that you go optically?
Yeah, because we are trying to make a photonic integrated system. So we are going to reduce the size and the way of the component. So in order to do that, we have moved to this new type of radiometer where we are having photon integrated circuit of around millimeters a size, and the resonator is also small. So maybe if in that solution that you are proposing, we will need of more power consumption, more size, because this Martinala project is not only for our radiometer. Several systems will be integrated also in each CubeSat to another interesting investigation from a group of Complutense de Madrid, companies as Zener. So we are very limited in some space but, power consumption.
Maybe I can add a little bit, because we are not looking for a source. This is actually a detector. And maybe if you go to the schematic of the radiometer, Jessica, that would be easier here, right? So the actually the millimeter wave is the radiometer input. And that's the signal we are aiming to detect, because that's what's going to come from the Earth or from the cosmic background. So we need to detect that signal. And it's on a millimeter wave range, above 100 gigahertz. And it's going to be detected by the Whispering Galley resonator with an extremely high Q. And the way to detect is by modulating the optical signal with this millimeter wave in the resonator. They both, the optical and the millimeter wave signals interact in the Whispering Galley resonator. And why we need the other wavelength is not for up conversion, it's for down conversion. And that's what is going to bring down the frequency of the millimeter wave we are detecting down to a achievable millimeter or manageable bandwidth of the photodetectors. And that's connected with the question that was asked by Juan Pastor, that the bandwidth of the photodetector doesn't need to be extremely wide, because it's we can handle that by the wavelength spacing of the LO and the the wavelength of the carrier that they is embedded in the resonator. And that's why we need this continuous wave tuning of the two optical wavelengths, so we can down convert independently of what the frequency of the radiometer that we want to use, because the Whispering Gallery, of course, is going to be, and the antenna will be tuned to the resonator, to the frequency, the millimeter wave frequency we aim to detect. But the idea is that the whole principle can be used for any frequencies.
Okay, understand. Maybe I'm pretty sure that the Herschel Planck mission, which has been flying since quite a few years now, was a mission which was launched in the end of the 80s from the European Space Agency in the context of the cosmic background radiation, 4K radiation measurement. And that is very much focused on millimeter, some millimeter wavelengths. And that used essentially as sources, because it detects the low frequency background from the universe. It's based on GaN for millimeter, GaN diode, tuned GaN diode, and the multiplier to go to some millimeter. And as detector, you said, Joseph Chang, very, very extremely sensitive cryogenic detector. But, I understand here the context.
That's the point. Yeah, that's the point. We don't want to use cryogenesis. And that's the Whispering Galley resonator. It's a room temperature.
Yeah, that's your issue. Very high Q, but room temperature. Excellent. Yeah, very good.
Thanks for your question.
Thank you very much, Guillermo, for your additional explanation. It's always a pleasure to have you here. And congratulations, Jessica, for the clarity of the explanation of such a complex project. Congratulations to all the team, because it's excellent how you finished these specifications of this project. I'm for sure that it will become a device flying in the space. Thank you.
Thank you.